My name is Connor McGee, and it is truly my honor to be your master of ceremonies tonight. I would first like to welcome everyone in attendance here at Pepsi Center and thousands of fans watching on local, national, and international broadcasts of tonight's event. It is now my pleasure to introduce Gavin's family and special guests that are joining us on the field for tonight's ceremony. First, from the Mammoth, please welcome President and General Manager, Steve Gubbin. Also welcome Gavin's longtime friend and agent, Rich Furlong. And Gavin's mother and father, Joanne and Mary Prout. To begin tonight's ceremony, we ask you please direct your attention to Pepsi Vision as we look back on the career of number 9, Gavin Prout.
March 14th, 1978, in Kamloops, British Columbia, Canada, a boy named Gavin was born. Shortly after, he was adopted by Barry and Joanne Prout, who brought him back to grow up in Whitby, Ontario, with his younger sister, Nikki, and older brother, Barry John, also adopted. At age 4, Gavin started playing hockey, and a year later, lacrosse. He loved both sports, but lacrosse was the one that won Gavin's heart. He had the skill, but it was his infectious passion that took Gavin Prout from good to great. In high school, he was the lacrosse MVP all 4 years and was the athlete of the year in 3 of those 4 years, all while maintaining honorable GPA and valedictorian status. Gavin Prout had all the ingredients for a leader. He played junior lacrosse in his hometown of Whitby, Ontario, for the Whitby Warriors. In 1997, at the age of 19, Prout led the Warriors to their first Minto Cup championship in 12 years. In 1999, Prout led the league in scoring with 132 points and took the Warriors to their second Minto Cup in 3 seasons. Prout finished junior with 676 points, ranking him 25th all-time in Canadian Junior A lacrosse history. Prout's head-turning production and drive to win shot him to the top of the list for the 2001 NLL Entry Draft in Buffalo, New York. Gavin was selected first overall by the New York Saints and was honored as a member of the All-Rookie Team in 2002. In 2003, Prout chose to come to Colorado and sign as a free agent with the Mets for the 2004 season. And it was then that number 9 was just getting started.
Oh,
We are now in the presentation portion of the ceremony. I'd like to call on Mammoth Captain John Grant, who Gavin's mother is being presented with flowers. Thank you, Joanne, for raising such a fantastic lacrosse player. Next, I'd like to call on longtime teammate of Gavin's, John Gallant, to make a special presentation to Gavin on behalf of the Mammoth organization.
Johnny!
I love Johnny.
Oh, wow.
That's really cool.
This jersey is an impenetrable, airtight frame, making sure no one will wear the number 9 jersey for the Colorado Mammoth ever again.
Woo!
Now, it is my pleasure to call on Mammoth General Manager Steve Gunn, Governor and architect of the 2006 Colorado Mammoth Champions Cup team that Gavin played on. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Gunn.
Thanks, Gunn. Thank you all for being here. Thanks for Gavin for being here and his parents who flew in from Ontario, and thank you so much. The great Vince Lombardi once said, to be successful, a man must exert an effective influence upon his brothers and upon his associates, and the degree in which he accomplishes this depends on the personality of the man, the incandescence of which he is capable, the flame of fire that burns inside of him, the magnetism which draws the heart of other men to him. There is no question in my mind that Gavin Prout drew the hearts of other men to him. He was a leader of the highest order. You somehow always knew that when you entered a game with Gavin in the front, that something special was bound to happen. A captain, by virtue of his title, is expected to lead. Not all teams are willing to follow. Gavin gave his blood, his toil, his tears, his sweat, and because of that, his teams follow. If the great Gary Gate was the face of the Colorado Mammoth, and the ever-passionate Brian Langtry was the heart and soul of the Mammoth, then Gavin surely was the mind and soul of the Mammoth. His internal fire to win permeated the entire team. Every player embodied his direction. He led by example. You could feel his presence in games. When he spoke in the locker room, you listened. Never in the history of this franchise has one player possessed so much charisma, so much magnetism, that the players and fans alike were drawn to him and wanted to be near him. He had an incandescence that drew you in like a flame that mesmerizes the night sky. That flame burned bright within Gavin Prout. Of course, he will always be known as a great goal scorer, always be known as a tremendous passer and playmaker, but what made Gavin Prout the great player that we all know him to be was his amazing ability to effect change in a game when you didn't expect it. A great hit, a fight when the time came in a game that warranted it to spark his team, when the bench or the huddle needed a calm voice or the encouragement to dig just a little deeper for a win. Paul Bear Bryant said, it's not the size of the dog in the fight, but the size of the fight in the dog. He couldn't have captured Gavin's style any better. Not the biggest player, but certainly played with the biggest heart. Gavin will be remembered here at Pepsi Center by the Mammoth. He won't just be recalled. And the burning image that will always epitomize his career will be as a captain when presented with the Champions Cup in 2006, he hoisted it above his head as the MVP of the playoffs that season. As our gift to Gavin, we present that image to Gavin today for his outstanding efforts on behalf of the tremendous career with the Colorado Mammoth. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my very distinct pleasure and privilege to present to you your captain, the mind and the soul of the Mammoth, the outstanding leader, Gavin Prout.
retirement is such a simple concept and a very difficult decision to make. In every athlete's life, retirement is inevitable. I've had bloody battles each and every time I stepped on the floor. Yet, the decision to retire was one of the toughest battles I had to come to terms with in my life. With my lingering injuries, me not getting any younger, obviously, the decision was the right way for me at this time. Although I would love to play another 10, 20, 30 years, if my body would allow it, which it won't. But 30 years has taken its toll. My body will no longer do what my mind wants it to effectively at this level of competition. I have been fortunate enough to play for 12 seasons here in the NLL. I've played for 3 different teams and enjoyed every second of the competition on the floor. I've won at almost every possible level. I've played at lacrosse. 4 World Outdoor Championships. Thank you. I've won Outdoor World Championships, Outdoor Indoor World Championships, Mental Lacrosse Cup Championships, National Canadian Championships. But the one championship that really sticks out in my mind is the 2006 Champions Cup I won. I was drafted in 2002 to New York and played there for 2 years before I had the opportunity to choose where I wanted to play next. G. Nash, Nick Carlson, and myself each had plenty of teams interested in us playing for them. We all decided to come to Denver to further our lacrosse careers there. This choice wasn't by mistake. We all came to this decision because we found the city of Denver was the best choice for us independently. And this goes to show how great of an organization in Colorado Man truly are. I've had so many fond memories here at the Pepsi Center over the 9 seasons I've played here. And there are so many people responsible for my success that it would be impossible for me to thank everybody, but I'm going to try. First and foremost, my parents. They truly are my biggest supporters and fans, and they always have been and always will be. Without you guys consistently sacrificing hobbies and having your lives put on back. Year in and year out, it's true to learn. The lessons and disciplines you guys each taught me every day transferred into my lacrosse, as well as my professional career. And I cannot thank you enough for everything you've given me to allow me to be the best person I can be both on and off the floor today. Without you, I wouldn't be here today on this special occasion. I want to thank you for continuing to sign me year in and year out and having the faith in me to lead your team as a captain for 6+ years. I appreciate you giving me the ability to play here in front of all these passionate fans. And this particular event makes what you and this organization the classiest in the NLL. I'm so fortunate to be associated with you. Steve's right-hand man and women, Don Sundley, Alex Santiago, Bill Hall, they're right by Steve's side throughout my career. They took care of all the off-field aspects for us as players so we could really focus on just our task at hand on the field. They took care of all the distractions and made traveling very, very easy for us. So I want to thank them for all their hard work. I want to thank the staff, Conkey Sports, the video crew. I mean, can you believe it? They actually make us look pretty good, don't they? The interns, the ticket agents, security, that's you, Gracie, wherever you are. Right down to the ushers. Without you guys, events like this would not be possible. I've met many of you throughout my years of playing, and I really do appreciate the amount of passion you show for your work, for yourselves, as well for us as players. So thank you for your support and hard work. I want to thank my agent sitting here, Rich Furlong. Thank goodness he was able to make it. Thanks, Rich. I want to thank you for supporting me each and every year, battling for my wishes to come true, my contracts, and getting the best of Steve Gavin each and every year you can do. You truly are the best agent and friend I could ask for. I want to thank all the past coaches of the organization for their guidance, their preparations, their game plans, and advice. All of that has allowed me to succeed in the game that I love at this professional level. And I really do appreciate the faith that you all put in me as a player, and I'm grateful for that. So thank you. To the media, guys like Josh Gross, Willie B., Altitude Sports. I'll say it again, Altitude Sports, because they deserve it. All of your supporters, you guys are truly the ones that are helping grow the buzz and lacrosse of this great sport. Your help getting interested by everybody, and the reason why lacrosse is the fastest growing sport in North America. So it's my friends and my family, some here, some who can make it, some who flown in. I thank you for that. And for the family who've been watching online, thank you for always backing me, supporting me, and giving me advice, even if I don't ask for it. All the kind words, they don't fall upon deaf ears. I really do appreciate everything that you guys have done for me. I'm almost done, trust me. Lastly, I guess, my teammates, guys, thanks very much. You guys are my supporting family on the road, the soldiers of the battle. Beside each and every game, this honor couldn't have been achieved without the help of each and every one of you guys. Although the team changed players and dynamics each and every year I was there, there was always a common theme. And that was to battle for a family member sitting beside you in a dressing room and across from you on the bench. You guys truly are what made traveling each and every weekend fun, actually. And I look forward to seeing my teammates each and every weekend because you guys really are a special group. I will miss playing beside you guys dearly. Although teammates come and go, I'm fortunate enough to see that the majority of them became great friends, and that will continue to speak with long after my career, lacrosse career has ended. And that, I am most thankful for. And last but not least, fans, you guys! Guys, there would be no Colorado Mammoth, believe me. This place truly is, and honestly does have the best fans in the game of lacrosse. It really is the loudest house. Having the support of each and every one of you guys, game in and game out, regardless of the score, really made my playing days here in Denver enjoyable. I hope the amount of passion I displayed on the floor was a small percentage of the passion I see around here every single day in a lacrosse game. I loved every single second I was able to compete in front of you, on and off the floor, and I'm extremely thankful and fortunate to be able to share a special night with each and every one of you. Your support is what allowed me to call Denver my home away from home for so many years. And I will cherish every moment I had here. I'm leaving the game with nothing but fond memories. And you guys, the fans, are at the forefront of each and every one of those memories. So thank you very, very much.
Here to present Gavin Prout's banner, please welcome former teammates of Gavin, Nick Carlson, Tom Effington, Dan Carey, Dan Stroop, Pat Coyle, and Chris Gill.
As we honor both represented nations with the singing of O Canada, followed by the singing of the Star Spangled Banner, as performed this evening by Jake Schroeder.
Yes, finally.
O Canada, our home.
home and native land. True baby love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Dawn's early light, what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly. And the riders read them, the bombers singing in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner